So we've got Brady Ioannidis on the call today for Intros with Kato. Brady's a linebacker. He's the class of 2022. He's one of our CFC100s in the top 100. He's 6'4", 230 pounds, Kitchener native out of Ontario. He's playing down in the States right now. Brady, how are you?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks for taking your time on a Sunday to talk with us. We were speaking just briefly that you had a game yesterday. How was that?
That game went great. We got a win late with a big field goal. It was tied 35-35, 3 seconds left, and our kicker put it in.
You're at a Christ School, correct?
Yeah, Christ School in Arden, North Carolina.
Is this your first semester down there? Or?
Yeah, this is my first semester down here. I've been here for like a month and a half, maybe 2 months.
Just tell us a little bit about how you got started in your football career up to where you are now.
As the story goes, my mom always used to tell this story whenever we have company around. But I would always, like, ever since I was like really little, like 3 or 4, I would go, I'd watch the Raiders with my dad on Sundays. And, you know, I'd then start begging her, can I play football? Can I play football? And then one day she finally cracked when I was 5 and signed me up, and I just sort of ran with that.
What position did you start playing at, and what are you playing at now?
So my very first season, I was center. I won the Pancake Award. and then I moved to linebacker for like a good 8-9 years. And then for the past couple seasons, when I started getting some serious height, I moved to defensive end and outside linebacker.
So what position do you like better, and what do you like most about both?
I definitely like defensive end. I love rushing the passer. I love it. It's so much fun. It's a pure competition rep, and the best player will win that rep, and you can really see who's dominant on those one-on-one battles. And especially once you start showing yourself as an edge threat and teams start double-teaming you or chipping you with a tight end, then you're like, you know what, that's some serious respect that they're showing me, and it just only makes you want to work harder.
What type of player would you say that you are, personality-wise? Are you a bit feisty? Or, well, for it to be a DN, you kind of have to be that, but how would you say you play?
I'm very physical, but I'm very smart with it too, you know, like, it's very calculated what I'm doing, especially at both positions, at linebacker and the end. I've been told that I have a high football IQ, which is good for linebacker. But, you know, I can read the play really well. But when it's go time and I got to pull the trigger, get downhill, I'm pulling the trigger and laying the boom.
It sounds like you're in the perfect spot, the perfect position.
Yeah.
What type of coaching do you best respond to?
I definitely respond to a challenge, you know, like in practice and in games, I'm always trying to be dominant. I'm always trying to win every rep. But especially if a player or a coach challenges me to do something, then it just takes my game to a whole new level.
Do you prefer more of the coaches in your face, or you don't really need that type of external motivation?
Definitely, I'm fine with both, but definitely if I need a coach to get in my face, I would appreciate if a coach got in my face. And so, you know, it definitely helps. If he really needs to light a fire, then if he wants to get in my face, I'm all for it.
During the season, what's your favorite part about football?
During the season, I love it all. I love it all. But, you know, if I had to pick one, it'd definitely be the games. Because, you know, you're the long week. It's a long week of practice preparation. You're watching film. You're going through scout team and stuff. You're getting half, like, you know, not getting full game looks, you know. And then game time comes around. You're let loose and you just get to go out there, compete.
Does your school have any team traditions?
Christ School is full of traditions. Like, it is full of traditions. We walk, so for home games and stuff, we walk behind the field and then up a hill before we come down and onto the games. And then we have a chapel here with a bell called the Angelus, and it's rung before and if we win after the game. And then on away games, if we win those games, we get to come back, ring the bell. Every player gets to ring the bell and, you know, let everyone know.
What are your goals for this season?
Well, team goals, of course, are, you know, we kind of had a shaky start. We dropped the first two games just based off mental mistakes and penalties. Then our team goals, it's win out, of course. And if there's talks of if all things go well COVID-wise, then we'll have like a state playoff kind of thing. So, of course, it would be to win that if that ends up happening. But individual goals, it's definitely get to double-digit sacks, some solid TFLs, get some solid film. You know, that's kind of the individual goals.
Did you have to be creative with how you trained in the off season because you were limited in the resources that you had? What did you do to prepare yourself for what you're doing right now?
You know, as the start of the pandemic happened, and as pretty much every player was doing, I was just trying to find ways to work. I was in my basement grinding on the field with my dad, doing like pass rush and footwork drills. And then when gym started to open up, it was either phase two or three, I forget. And I got in the gym with my trainer, Jesse Collins, at Collins Athletic Performance. And he really helped me gear up to making the transition down here. You know, I can't say enough about that guy. He's a great guy. Helps me a lot.
We ranked you on the class of 2022 on our CFC100 prospect rankings, which are on CanadaFootballChat.com. And anyone listening can access those with their gold membership. Just tell me, being ranked, does that motivate you at all?
Well, of course, there's some motivation because, you know, you get some accolade after so much hard work. It's great to have a payoff. But, you know, also at the same time, you're never really going to be satisfied until you see that number one spot with your name next to it. So, you know, if anything, that is the motivation, not being number one.
Let's talk about the recruiting process a little bit. Have you seen many scouts and coaches come around and watching your guys' games? Or what about the youth sport coaches up here? Have you been in talks with any of the coaches or recruiters so far?
In regards to youth sport, pretty much every OUA program I have either talked to, or coaches like follow me on Twitter and email and stuff like that. But as of down here, there's the biggest question for me is how much American film do I have, right? Because you know, I've only played two games down here. Well, three games now. But right now, there's coaches that are apparently calling my coach. That's what he's let me know. But I just need some more film under the books before things start getting serious, I think.
Well, and you're still fairly early in the process, right?
Yeah.
How do you handle that stress or anxiety, if it even creates any of that for you? Or are you fairly grounded in this whole process so far? Are you enjoying it?
I kind of just like the grind in silence, not really get mixed up with the noise. You know, if I do what I'm trying to do, at the end of the day, things are going to come. And if things don't come, then it's fine either way. But you know, I'm just going to keep grinding, and no matter what happens, just strive to be the best player I can be.
What are you looking to study at the next level academically?
Either business or kinesiology or something like that, because I guess my dream job, other than an NFL player, would probably be an agent or a GM. You know, that'd be pretty good. So you get some business in there, or some sports science, just anything around football, I'd have a great time.
Going back a little bit into terms of the performance expectations, and, you know, if you have any, the standards that people place on you, either by yourself or by your parents, friends, family, coaches, and then also living, you know, away from your family down in the States, how do you handle all of that?
You know, it was definitely tough. It was definitely tough when I first got down here. You know, I was a little homesick. But, you know, once the season starts ramping up and you're just getting into it, then, you know, it gets easier. And it's all about making, you know, good time management, making sure you're really focusing on what your goals are and whatever those are. And that's really the key to it.
What was the biggest adjustment for you?
The biggest adjustment was definitely, it had to be like doing everything by myself. Everything was independent. So, you know, I had to make sure I'm eating, make sure I'm doing like proper hydration before the games, nutrition and stuff like that, making sure I'm getting good sleep, making sure all my homework and my school's taken care of, and on the football field, making sure I'm going out there and doing what I do.
How was the transition from three down to the four down game?
I think I'm definitely suited for a more four down defender because, you know, especially with the American game and stuff, it's a lot more condensed. The field is more condensed. There's only 11 players, but everything seems a lot tighter. And I just feel like I work with that a lot better, and I'm able to sort through that and get to the play. But, you know, also coverage wise, without the slots running up, getting the running start makes that a lot easier, let me tell you. That would be the biggest thing from three to four.
Can I put you on the spot and ask you which one you like better?
I'd have to say four down. So extra down to get after the QB.
So where do you hope football is going to take you in the future?
I mean, I'd be lying if I said I didn't want to play in the NFL. That is the end goal. you know, get there at the biggest stage, lots of money, you know, just getting to do what I love, you know, but that's definitely where I hope. And it pays for my education. That'd also be great. But football is definitely, I feel like, has the opportunity to give lots of opportunities.
What would be your dream school to play at?
Ohio State. I'm a Buckeye, man. I'm a Buckeye. I love Ohio State. Yeah, that would have to be the dream school. You know, seeing Nick Bosa, Joey Bosa, Chase Young, all those edge rushers, you just want to be one of those guys. So, you know, that's what I strive to do every day.
Before we close off here, we're going to play a quick game called, where I'm going to say two things and you're going to tell me the one that best that you prefer. Or I'm going to say a statement and you just tell me the first thing that comes to your mind, okay?
Okay.
What are you watching on Netflix?
Right now, I was watching last night. It was, I don't think it was on Netflix, but it was Borat. I was watching Borat, and that was pretty good. You know, pretty funny guy.
Do you prefer dogs or cats?
I'm definitely a dog guy. Definitely a dog guy. You gotta get active with them, play with them a little bit more. And you know, cats that act like dogs are definitely cool too. But I'd have to.
Do you know a cat that acts like a dog?
There's one. So my dorm parent, right? His name's Mr. Rebecombe. His cat is literally like a golden retriever. It plays fetch. It does everything. It's crazy.
Is a hot dog a sandwich?
No. Hot dog's a hot dog. Sandwiches. It has to be hot dog. No. It's just plain and simple. No.
Pineapple on pizza or not?
If I had to pick, I definitely not. Because the sweetness with the pizza, just I'm not a fan of it. But you know, I'm not gonna turn it down if it's there.
Think vacation, adventure race, or sit on a beach.
Adventure. I'm a big adventure guy. You know, you get to experience something. You know, do something, and it's definitely better than just relaxing. You can relax at home. You don't have to be on a beach. But you know, getting an adventure is just once in a lifetime opportunities. So you got to take those.
What's on your music playlist?
A lot of rap. You know, I'm not even going to lie right here. There's a little bit of Taylor Swift. There's a little bit of Taylor Swift on there. Like I vibe with the Taylor Swift, but yeah, you know, it's very, very rangy. Got some Pop Smoke and some Taylor Swift. So works well for me.
Okay. So to answer me this. So I listen to a wide range of music, yeah, except for rap, because to be honest, I don't even know where to begin to start to listen. So who would you recommend that I start on my journey of learning about rap?
I mean, you'd have to start with definitely more of like a pop rap kind of mix, like an R&B guy, maybe Drake or somebody like that. You know, he kind of blends the two really well. And, you know, I feel like that would ease into it.
What is your spirit animal?
Oh, spirit animal. I don't know. Tiger or lion or something like that. King of the jungle. Gotta be him.
Who would win a fight between Spider-Man and Batman?
That's a tough one. I think Spider-Man whoops him, though. To be honest, I think Spider-Man whoops Batman. Just because he got those webs. He got those webs and, like, he has now, if we're going, like, Tony Stark's, like the new kind of Spider-Man, he has like technology like Batman, but you know, he's just got that extra edge. I think he pulls out.
Do you kick the single to tie the game or do you go for two to win the game?
You got to win. Go big or go home. That's my philosophy on that one. So you got to go for two.
All right, Brady. Well, thanks for coming on here. I appreciate you taking the time on your Sunday to have a chat with me.
Yeah, no problem. I appreciate it. Thank you.
And good luck with the rest of your season.
Yeah, thank you.
Looking for more exclusive Canadian recruiting content? Become a CFC Insider Gold or Silver member today for access to rankings, analysis, and the latest recruiting news from across the country.